How much should I exercise? Is exercise going to be beneficial or is it going to harm my dog? Hi, I'm Debbie Famlis. I'm the founder of Response 5. It's a neurological restoration that's applied to your dog that you do at home as part of their therapy for DM. So welcome. And today I wanted to talk to you about physical exercise. I get a lot of questions within my clinic. And by the way, I've been operating my clinic for 14 plus years. So thousands of dogs have come through my clinic. And unfortunately, many of them with degenerative myelopathy. So one of the most asked questions is exercise. Do I exercise? How much should I exercise? Is exercise going to be beneficial or is it going to harm my dog? And there's a piece I want to add to this because it's a missing link I find often when you're looking for information. And that is, it really is a whole picture of working with your dog. And that is your dog's personality, your dog's age. And it's also your personality and your thinking on how you want your dog to live out its best life. So as much as it's exercise, we have to incorporate the emotions and behaviors of both yourself and your dog when we're talking about the best exercise for your dog with DM. Yes, I'm a firm believer that your dog needs to keep moving. We need to keep all the nerve endings going, the muscle going, and the brain going. So exercise is important. What we don't want to do with DM specifically is we don't want to overexhaust. Now, if you've been dealing with your dog with DM for a while, you understand that there's, you know, good days and then there's really low days. So it's kind of this unfortunate roller coaster of good and not so good days. So what will happen if you overextend your dog with exercise, whether that's intentional exercise of walking and moving, or if it's just a big play day for your dog? What you'll find when they're overexhausted is that the next day, two or even 3 days, they have that really down day. So with DM, it's really important not to overexhaust. Now I say that, but really, interestingly enough, there's two mindsets that go with that. So you may be of the mindset that I want to preserve my dog's energy and his stability and mobility for as long as possible to keep him happy, healthy, and around our family for as long as possible. And then there's another mindset that I come across often in my clinic, and is that, you know what, my dog is 12, 13 years old. He's had a great life, and I want him to go out having a great life. So if he wants to run hard, play hard, by all means, we're going to do that. And if he has a few down days, we'll deal with it then. But I'm not going to stop my dog from having fun. So you need to kind of figure out what category you're in. If you're looking to preserve your dog's stability for as long as possible, when we exercise, we have to exercise to a limit where it's beneficial and not harming, so that we're seeing less and less of those roller coaster days. So how do we do that? Well, if your dog is just walking, then we want to do straight line walking. So what I mean by straight line walking is that we don't want the dog weaving back and forth as they're walking. It's very hard on their stability. Straight line walking is when you have that shorter leash and they're walking straight forward, right? It doesn't have to be inclines, but just walking in that nice pattern is just going to keep their brain and mindset happy, as well as keeping the muscles working properly and everything working straight line. That makes sense, right? So straight line walking is a very important piece. If you're taking them out to physical therapy or water therapy, there's a few questions I want you to ask. And of course, you want to know all the details of what the protocol is. I want you to have them analyze where your dog is at with DM. And I want you to really make sure that at each session you ask exactly what they did and for the length of time. So even if your dog is going in for, say, a 20-minute session, I'm thinking that they probably won't be exercising your dog for 20 minutes. So maybe they're doing 2 or 3 minutes of exercise, then they're taking a break for 5-6 minutes, then doing a little bit more, a little bit water therapy, and then taking a break. If that's not happening and you're seeing, you know, that there's a crash after any form of physiotherapy or water therapy, that's probably why, because they're using up too much of that therapy time actually doing exercise. And I know all this costs money, but you don't want them running or working hard for that 10, 15, 20 minutes if they can't handle it and they're having those crash days. So just be really aware ask questions. And if you are seeing that downtime after physiotherapy, then it's time to go back and have that rediscussion with them so that you make sure that your dog's getting the optimal out of that. And the money as well, right? Because any type of disease, especially degenerative myelopathy, you can really run down that rabbit hole of spending a ton of money. So you want to make sure that the right therapy in the right amount of time, and that your dog's benefiting from that, not getting a decrease in stability after that. Even if it's not overdone, if you're noting that your dog's just not benefiting from it, then it's just not the right protocol. So don't feel like you're stuck into one therapy because you read an article in on DM and it says you must do this and that. Okay, you have to understand what is right for your dog. There's interesting research out there now that states that when your dog is walking and has the opportunity to stop and smell the world around them, how amazing that is for their mental health. Your dog may not be able to go as far as fast anymore. If they can get out and use their nose and enhance their mind state, then that's all part of the beauty of dealing with your dog with DM. Please remember that this journey is between you and your dog. What works for the both of you is vitally important. Take it one step at a time, one day at a time. You can do this. I know you can. And from my end, when I work with dogs and families from around the world, I have this type of support with them on a daily basis. I'm really close by to them for emails and suggestions and making those unique protocols for your dog. Because what I understand is that we have to take this a stage at a time and make it really unique for you and your dog. So until then, check out response5.com, head over to YouTube, subscribe, and please hit that notification bell so that you get more and more of these videos in your inbox so that I can help you help your dog in the most unique way.